All right, Senator Marco Rubio making headlines this morning after tweeting an edited clip of an interview Democratic Representative Ilhan Omar did last year with Al Jazeera and writing, I am sure the media will now hound every Democrat to denounce this statement as racist, right? So here's the clip Rubio referenced in its entirety. Watch.
A lot of conservatives in particular would say that the rise in Islamophobia is a result not of hate, but of fear, a legitimate fear, they say, of quote-unquote jihadist terrorism, whether it's Fort Hood or San Bernardino or the recent truck attack in New York. What do you say to them?
I would say our country should be more fearful of white men across our country, because they are actually causing most of the deaths within this country. And so if fear was the driving force of policies to keep America safe, Americans safe inside of this country, we should be profiling, monitoring, and creating policies to fight the radicalization of white men.
All right, so back with me now are Sahil Kapoor and Amy Parnes. Also joining me is former White House Senior Director for the Obama Administration, Nayara Haque. Great to have everyone with us. Nayara, let me begin with you. We reached out to Senator Marco Rubio's office for comment. We did not get one. We did invite him to come on. He did not provide a statement. He does, however, have on his Twitter feed, and we have this. My tweet wasn't about her. It was about the double standard in how many in media would react. And sure enough, you make it sound as if she said we should fear white supremacists. She didn't. She said white men. First of all, he's trying to get off on a technicality here. I think anyone who watches that with any kind of, like, just a little bit of context understands what she's talking about, the radicalization of white men and domestic terrorism and white supremacy. What is Marco Rubio doing here?
Oh, he's totally playing into this fear of white genocide that we're seeing become a popular campaign theme. 3 days ago, the FBI director said that a white terror and white nationalism is the number one threat in the United States, and it's coming from this fear, mistaken fear of white genocide. And so for Marco Rubio to take an image of a woman wearing a headscarf who was black and who was a refugee and saying, look, she's scared of you, she's trying to take over you, that's what he's playing into. Unfortunately, this can have deadly consequences because this fear has become violent. That's where it turns into white supremacy. And if you look at any of the studies in the last 2 or 3 years, the uptick in hate crimes across the country, crimes in general, they call it terrorism now, is from right-wing extremists. Unfortunately, this is turning into policy. In the early Trump administration, Donald Trump decided that he was going to take the unit called Countering Violent Extremism, strip away any of the authorities to monitor right-wing terror, and call it Countering Islamic Extremism. Extremism in all types, from all beliefs, is harmful to Americans, and so we should have a holistic view of this problem.
All right, you brought up some really interesting points. Let's put some data here on the screen. This is according to the Anti-Defamation League. 78% of U.S. terrorism deaths in 2018 came at the hands of white supremacists, not radical Muslim extremists or whatever else the administration calls global jihadist or terrorist movements that may be linked to attacks here in the U.S. Sahil, let me ask you your thoughts about this. How do you explain the disconnect between what Marco Rubio tried to do with his tweet against the Democratic congresswoman and the facts and the statistics as we just highlighted?
I think the core of this, Eamon, is Rubio channeling his grievances about the fact that every time President Trump says something that he and other Republicans are asked, did they condemn it? He's clearly in an uncomfortable position here because he's a strong supporter of President Trump, but he's also the man who called him a con artist in 2016. Aggressive, fierce criticism of the man he is now supporting. So I think he's been on this grievance train for a while, arguing that he's getting some sort of a raw deal by the fact that when the president says offensive things, people are asked to weigh in on it. I'm just so struck by how much things have changed for Marco Rubio since 2013, when he was splashed on the cover of Time magazine with the words Republican savior, to now he's supporting the man who he clearly had some problems with.
All right, and here, interesting enough, we just actually got a statement from Marco Rubio by the time this segment started. So that's how quickly we were able to turn things around here. Let me read this to you. It says that if a Republican grouped all men of any background or ethnicity together in any negative context, especially terrorism, many in the media would immediately demand that other Republicans disavow their statement. But when Representative Omar suggested white men, not white supremacists or white nationalists, white men, pose a greater danger than jihadists. Many in the media rushed to her defense and attacked me for pointing out this double standard. So, Amy, let me get your thoughts and reaction to Marco Rubio, Senator Marco Rubio's explanation there.
I mean, he's trying to walk it back a little bit, but not much. I don't think you can say a lot about this. He's clearly, it's a Trump playbook kind of thing. It's a Republican playbook thing. They are using this woman, this congresswoman, as a foil. That's how they rally their base. That's how they get everyone excited. And that's exactly what he's doing here. And he's kind of standing his ground, I think, in his own way.
Yeah, I was going to say, even if he was trying to be genuine about the point that he was making, you would have played the unedited, unaltered video. The fact that you chose to kind of retweet a altered video, a video that takes out of the statements of the congressman some very important context, I think undermines his own argument there. Sahil and Amy, thank you very much. Naira, stick around. We're going to talk to you again in a little bit. Still ahead.